Students, in this video we are going to see the imperative sentences. Before I am going to teach active voice and passive voice, I taught you the kinds of sentence statement in a positive and negative and question types. There are two types in that. What are they? Yes or no type and WH model. You are very strong in that form and the topic, and now we are going to see the imperative sentence. Okay, it's very easy, because we are using the imperative sentence day by day, okay, and daily life also, yeah, but not in passive, okay. You see here, the passive was imperative sentence, yes, the passive was in imperative sentence. Various ideas like commands, orders, requests may be expressed in passive, okay. For various ideas like commands, orders, and request may be expressed in passive voice, but we are not using like this passive voice in spoken form, but they are formed only in an interview or indirect giving order something, okay, in day-to-day life. How to use that the passive voice here? I would like to give some formula. You are asked, or you are requested, or you are begged, or you are implored. Implored means you are the same beg, okay, fine. And you are ordered, or you are commanded, or you are told, or you are advised. After that, we have to use the two, then verb one form here, okay? Verb one. Listen, post the letter here, listen, please. Post the letter. Please post the letter, you are requested. They say, for example, please means you are asked very polite. Okay, suppose you write a letter and you do not have time to post the letter in person. So what will you do? So you will ask, you will request to anyone if you know such a person. Yeah, that then we have to use the, so in direct way, we should use the direct, active voice. Please post the letter. How to say passive voice? Okay, normally we are not using the passive voice form in the normal spoken English. But how to use here? So, you are requested. Because we want to do any work by others, we will have to talk the very polite manners. So, you are requested to hear the SAP formula. You should act like this. That's why I have given you. You are. Okay, then you are often then requested or asked or begged or implored, commanded, whatever it is as per the conditions, okay, as per the situations. You are requested, often then we have to do two. What we do? Post, okay. You are requested to post the letter, okay, do you understand? No? So, this is the imperative sentence, okay. Please post the letter. You are requesting to someone. Indirect. So change into passive voice. You are requested, okay, to post the letter. We should bring like this, okay, dears. Moving on, one more example is there.
One more example here. Shut the door. Is this active or passive? You are giving order to. You are ordering to someone to do. Okay, here. So is this active or passive? This is active voice because there is no P4, there is no P3 form. Okay? So how to change it to passive voice? I already told you. So when you find the imperative sentence, you write like this, you are. This is your difficult. It's very easy. When you find imperative sentence, you should convert like this, you are. Okay? Then what kind of sentence is order or request or polite or implored? So order, okay? You are ordered. You are ordered. Then what would I add next? To, okay? Then the same verb to shut. That's all. Shut the door. Then object you have to use here. One more example. Help the poor. So help the poor. So is this imperative sentence? Yeah, definitely. Because the sentence started with the verb. That is called imperative sentence. Okay, fine. So here there is a finite verb and this is an object, but there is no agent here. So what do we how to change? So this is a help the poor. You are requested, you are advised. We can consider like this. You are advised here. Yeah. Fine. So you come like this, you are. I already told you how to write, change it to passive voice. Okay, you are advised. You are advised. Then what to do? Yes. So you are advised to. We have to add the to, then help. Okay? Help the verb. You understand it too well. And under one, don't come late. Here, vanish. Here. Hey, here after don't come late. We go to school regularly, we go to school little late. Yeah, it's our habit, huh? No, it's not good. Don't come late. Your master is warning you. Yeah. So you are warned or asked. When you find a negative form, not to. Okay, fine. Not to come late. Okay. What we tell dear, the positive is a negative. Don't be late hereafter. So you are advised or you are asked not to be late. Right? Don't go there. So you are asked or you are warned not to go there. Okay? So the same way, don't come late. This is the active voice. And when we change it to passive voice, you also should be added here and warned or asked, you are asked not to come late hereafter. You understand? So here is the be form verb and then we be form, that is called passive voice. Are you very clear, children? One more time, shut the door. This is an imperative sentence. Okay, change it to passive voice. You or should be added, then be the form as per the conditions. Okay, that means shut the door. It gives the order to someone. So we have to here, you are ordered to shut the door. Okay, don't forget. So you or should be here, then be the form. Okay. Two, then verb one. Then object is placed at the end of the sentence. Help the poor. Help the poor means this is the imperative sentence. Okay? You all should be brought here by you. So you are advised as per the situation. Help the poor. Because you can give the advice only. Hey, help the child, help the poor, please help me. Yeah, fine. So you are advised to help the poor. Don't come late. You are warned or asked not to come late. Okay, or you are commanded not to come late hereafter. Good, dear children, you are very strong in this. Yeah, good.